All right, guys, we're out here on the river. We're just looking at the sonar again. We got our stuff. We're just idling. All we're doing is looking. I found a lot of interesting spots. And surprising, the places where you think would have a lot of good structure, it's just hardly anything. And the places where you never suspect would have structure, there's a lot of good structure, because these dammed up rivers like this, there's, you know, Doug Stange in Fisherman says there's a river within the river. I'm finding old barge moorings, old, all kinds of things. Not just brush piles. Looks like we got something here. You probably can't see all this in the detail that I'm being able to look at it in. That's how you turn around quick in one of these. Just use it like a paddle. It'll get you turned around real quick. And so it's just fascinating. I mean, I'm really not, although I am set up for fishing, I'm not really looking to fish today. I'm just looking to look. Just to really try to get zeroed in on my electronics and get this thing dialed in the way I really want. I'm gonna have to spend some time reading and studying the manual. I only have it set for 50 feet or so. And we're just, got about a mile or so of water here that we're just looking at. We're starting toward the bank and progressively move deeper, coming up the other side, and just see what we can see, you know. And it's just fascinating. Seasons are starting to change. The water's not as clear as it was. It's starting to get sooty again. We had a nice, I guess, some cold front. Yeah, I guess we've seen that before. That's just the tree branches off the tree, I believe. I've seen that before. But, you may not be able to see any of that stuff. We're going back upstream, so we need to. Back upstream and against the wind, so slow down the chart speed. There's much more interesting stuff on that side of the river. Well, we need to get back up to the little portion we were trying to scan. Forgive the wind. I know the wind is kicking today, howling. Give the wind. Marking something in there. That's just off that little oak tree there. Let me mark that. Probably some little brim there off that oak tree. Exit. Get going again. We're about to hit a little creek right here. Stream, creek, whatever you want to call it. It's going to get real shallow real quick right here. Off in there. Guys come fish that. Not a lot. And that's it, just that little point comes right off there. Wants to push me back toward the bank, so you know, this is the area I've scanned before. There's some kind of something right there that comes up. There's a little hump there. There's just a lot of rocks right there. I've scanned that one before. Last year proved to be my absolute favorite spot, but I haven't caught a single thing off of it this year. It's amazing. So we're going through that long process of gathering data. And that data is gathered with this thing, electronics. Just looking and looking. I'm hearing a lot of fishermen say that they're just, you know, saving time by doing exactly what I'm doing right now, just looking. just get your electronics and just look. And they don't fish anywhere unless they're actually marking fish. And you have to learn the electronics, and so it's a learning curve. There's another little hump there. You got it set to 50 feet, and again, it'd be nice if this unit were about that long, right? This is a nice, almost a handheld unit. It's kind of nice, actually. One of the things I'm having trouble is how do I determine the rocks from the actual fish. But anyway, this is what we're probably going to end up doing today. I'm probably going to show my new channel cat chummer. Show that a little bit later on. But may even make a separate video on it. So there's some brush there, and now this is like, this is, should be like an old boat dock here, boat landing. It should be, that's used to be the old boat landing on the old river. And we just passed it, and I don't see a whole lot there. Covered up with a bunch of stuff. Passed right over it. I guess that's what that little vertical line there was, and a few things. And I'm guessing I'm seeing a lot of weeds here as well. Let me just have it sit right there. I need to have it mounted, like right there. And now we're just going to hold it like so. See if we can pick up this big rock here. I fish it off. I fish it sometimes as well. And there's that big rock right there. Big rock. That's what it's right there. That's why that big shadow's there. That's all it is, just one big honking rock just sitting there. That's it. It's just out there in the middle of the water, nothing else, huh? That's amazing. Coming up on some water mains and some other rocks. Cool. I mean, it's really kind of nice, you know. So I'm gonna have to do some more studying on just the electronics and how that works and stuff. I'm really hoping Hummingbird comes out with a Helix 9 or a Helix 10 or something like that. 9-10 Extreme would make this 100 times better, I think. See that tree branch there? That's it right there. Coming back to the boat dock. Back at the boat dock. I'm gonna run into anybody else's boat. Horse. Beautiful boat. A lot of guys are going with those aluminum boats like that now. lot of weed. I think it was just a lot of, caught the biggest drum of my life right here trolling with some fly rod. And an old, and one of my other lures, I think it was a Mickey Finn, I don't know what I think it was. Biggest drum I caught in my life, right up off those rocks over there. But, fishing is a learning art. You know, you have to continually be practicing your craft. It's not just go out when the weather's warm and have fun. It's not, you know. So you're seeing some more brush there. I thought this was just like a featureless bottom, and I'm actually quite surprised that I am seeing a lot of structure that I just never thought was there. So this is really, and there's another ledge there. You see it's a ledge because on the other side of it is on the other side of that ledge. Mark that, because it looks like something. There's like some big old cats sitting there. Mark. There's a lot of weeds down in here as well. I know there's lots of weeds and vegetation simply because when I fish and I hit the bottom, it always comes back up with some vegetation, which is fine. Conditions are starting to get a little hectic out here. There's a lot of wind out here. I'm not sure I'm going to stay out here much longer like this. Day. It feels like October, at least down here down south. But anyway, we're just going to keep doing this, and I'm seeing some little something here. I just don't know what I'm seeing, you know. Mark. You can zoom in if you want. And are those fish? Are those? No. No. See, there's sections of the river here. They got water mains, gas mains, pipes and stuff. And there's the pipe right there. There's the pipe. First time I've ever seen it. Gone up a mile, down a mile. Now we'll do the same thing. Once again, I'm thinking these are just weeds. Anyway, I don't want to bore you guys to death, but there's a fallen tree there. Back around here. I And I'll see you guys a little bit later. I mean, this is what we're going to basically do all day. I'm not going to really do much fishing. I may do a little bream fishing. I may head up river on a little creek I know and probably do a little bream fishing maybe. But I think primarily today what I want to do is just do exactly what I'm doing. Just try to learn the electronics and just learn them. I'm going to have to redo this. And when I finally do, I probably will hook back up with you guys. But now I need to adjust the speed again. And, this dude, man. Okay. But anyway. Going to go on the other side of the river and go down a little bit further. So we're just kind of running circuits until we cover this whole surface, sort of a whole area so thoroughly. Okay. I don't know how to do the recording function yet, so we'll be doing that. Records everything. I do have a chip in here. You know, it's right there. What I did was I took the old 4 gig chip from my camera and put it in here, and I bought a new 32 gigabyte chip for my camera, so I can just record a lot now. Before I couldn't record a lot, now I can record a whole lot of stuff. Starting to see a few trees starting to change colors. Right in the end of August, that's a little odd. I guess that one big cold front we've had is really, that one big cold front, and I think that's what's got some of these trees sort of freaking out. So we're gonna get a little bit further away from the shore this time. Just idling, man, just no problem. Hands-free thing that I talked about last time, really good going. Now, if we had a nice 10-inch screen, we could sit right here and just look at it, just right here. Okay. A little bit closer to the shore than I want to be, but we'll go with that. Again, we're just looking here. See that there, that thing? That's it right there, that little shadow, long shadow there. I think there's just lots of logs and stuff just strewed all over the bottom of the river. All right, I'm gonna keep doing this and then we'll check back with you. Probably I'll cut this video short and I'll do a whole other video on our new Brackleroy Lewis channel cat chummer, man. I love this thing. I was in the yard yesterday. It's fun, man. This thing is fun to throw, man. Really cast it out and broadcast well, but I'm testing it now. That's what I'm doing. So I'll talk to you guys later. Let me know what you think. Those of you guys who have just been using electronics for a while, give me some tips. What have you guys done what have you guys learned? What are the things that it's helped you with? We've got maybe some shad right here. I don't know if that's shad or if it's just interference. Maybe some more shad there. Alright guys, hope you find this helpful. Again, those of you who have been using these sorts of electronics for a while, let me know, man. How do you go about finding the fish where you are? And all that. I think it's going to take some time to learn the electronics. Just get out here, maybe even get out here every day and just start just running up and down and just seeing what you can see. Did. No time. I'll talk to you guys later. Maybe I'll get up there and do some real fishing or something. I'll see you. First bluegill of the day, finally. That's all we got. This little guy. I figure we ought to be able to get some channel cats up here around these logs and stuff, but nothing's really hitting the, I cannot find the channels this year, but we're doing a heck of a lot better on the Bream. We'll probably just go ahead and take this guy home. And, usually after the bait gets like that, I'll just go ahead and throw him off and rebait. And see, so we chum this area, and so it's just like, seems like they're just now starting to want to bite some after about 10 or 12 minutes or so. So we're keeping quiet because it's fairly shallow right here. Again, that float is just not moving at all. And it's bobbing now just because of the little waves or the wavelets because of the current and the wind. So there's the first one today. Very small, two fingers as we would say here. But it gets the skunk out of the boat. Tilting there. That's maybe something's on there. Or it could be slightly brushing up against the bottom. We'll reel it in and check it. Alright, be right back.